According to the ASEAN Travel and Tourism Competitiveness Report 2012, the ASEAN community is uniting 600 million citizens will account for almost 5% of global GDP. Almost 11% of this will be fueled by tourism industry. Tourism will create direct employment for 9.3 million people, or approximately 3.2% of all employment, and create direct employment for approximately 25 million people. This growth in tourism industry will be fueled by increased investment and free trade within the region, allowing ASEAN citizens to own up to 70% of shares in companies in the regions. Investment has begun. Although the ASEAN visions and structure cover security, socio-culture, and economy, but in practice, stepping into ASEAN is being led by the rapid investment. Indeed, it is sometimes easy to misunderstand that ASEAN and the ASEAN Economic Communities, or AEC, are not the same. Laws allowing ASEAN nationals greater freedom to invest alongside existing investment by international tourism businesses will lead to even larger competition. Companies will need to fight harder for market share in an already highly competitive tourism industry. If ASEAN's diverse local communities living alongside precious natural resources are not strong enough to cooperate and participate in defining the direction of tourism development, the ASEAN member states are likely to experience massive negative impacts on the local societies, cultures, and, of course, natural resources. There are serious risks that as tourism expands rapidly, local communities around ASEAN will rapidly develop in tourism destinations. Without sufficient planning, management, and local capacity building, this is likely to lead to problems such as pollution, noise pollution, poor waste management, resource scarcity, land speculation, community conflict, and exploitation of local communities members. Community-based tourism, or CBT, gives local community members opportunities to participate in planning, managing, and operating tourism products, services, and facilities for individuals and common benefits. While CBT may not be a main occupation or generate large sums of money for communities, it can be a powerful community development tool, supporting the sustainable management of social and environmental resources. Further, CBT can offer practical directions to balance and integrate conservation with development, providing that communities members are able to participate in and benefit from CBT development. The ASEAN region now has almost 20 years of experience developing tourism with people's participation. Every country has example of CBT lessons learned, including case studies of success and failures, have been analyzed, synthesized, and shared at national and regional levels through study tours and by academics, tourism development professionals at conferences. However, while several ASEAN countries have over 10 years experience developing CBT, such as Cambodia, Indonesia, Laos, PDR, Philippines, and of course Thailand, there has never been an official ASEAN forum for academics, practitioners, and organizations to exchange experience and knowledge about CBT. Probably this is the first time. Community-based tourism in other parts of the world, such as Africa and Latin America, has received harsh criticisms or, and sometimes even been just as a failure. Meanwhile, organizations which had previously played a key role in developing and supporting CBT as part of conservation and poverty alleviation strategies, such as SNV of the Netherlands or GIZ of Germany, has wrapped up or reduced support for CBT right now. However, in the ASEAN region, there are a significant number of communities which have successfully developed CBT and continue to operate and benefit from CBT programs several years after project and funding support has ceased. In Thailand, this is include Koh Yao Noi communities in Phanga, Mae Kampong community in Chiang Mai, and Hue He communities in Mae Hong Son. The Cambodian community-based Ecotourism Network, CCBN, has been able to continue promoting CBT across Cambodia with support from members and some assistance from the government. The Indonesian Ecotourism Network, Indicon, has worked in partnership with communities for over 15 years to build private sector capacities to partner with CBT. The literature reviews conducted as part of this research project discovered that the ASEAN region has a wealth of knowledge and especially fields experience which have not been documented or researched. Meanwhile, actually many interesting research papers have been written in national languages but not translated into English, which has led to limited dissemination and sharing of the findings. Today's Innovating CBT in ASEAN conference is the concluding part of the research project on quote exploring possibilities for the developments of a community-based tourism standard in ASEAN regions and beyond, unquote. An important part of the research was to stimulate exchange of ideas and experiences between government, the private sectors, local communities, and the other stakeholders. Part of the research project has been summarized in a conference book, Innovating CBT in ASEAN, Current Directions, New Horizons. The book has two main parts. The first part is the mentioned literature reviews and situation analysis of CBT in the 10 countries of ASEAN. The second part of the document presents case studies written by practitioners with direct field experience from 8 ASEAN countries. In today's conference, the 8 country case studies are presented. Writers were asked to present experiences related to supporting sustainability through the development of the CBT standard or guidelines, improved qualities and action at the policy levels. The conference focuses on innovation in CBT development. The eight country cases presented provide a quick overview of their national tourism and CBT development and provide one or several examples of CBT policies or CBT development initiatives in the particular country. In all country cases, a link is made to the development sub-guidelines and all standards. In Thailand, a draft CBT standard was developed and tested with several communities. After an initial discussions on a CBT standard in 2009 in Indonesia, no official standard has been implemented yet. In the Philippines, CBT-related standards, regulations, and codes are defined on different administrative levels. In the case of Lao PDR, a history of the development of CBT in Luang Nam Tha is presented, showing the relations of the development activity with institutional development. In Cambodia's a CBT standard was developed in 2009 and now receives renewed attention as it is assigned to lead the development of the ASEAN CBT standard. For Vietnam, the institutional setting of CBT developments in the north of the country is presented. In Malaysia, the government is supporting a homestay program but has not developed a CBT standard as of yet. Finally, in the fast emerging tourist destination of Myanmar, regulation of the CIT community involvement in tourism are part of a currently developed tourism master plan. As the case studies show, several promising initiatives are underway, headed by Cambodia, Thailand, and Myanmar. In other countries, important steps have been taken as well. And these combined experiences provide interesting insights in the challenge, lessons learned, and critical success factors when developing and implementing CBT standards in